There is no single story or even a similar thought process about creation in Hinduism. Only constant things in all ideas is the cyclical nature of time. In all Hindu, and for that matter even Buddhist and Jain texts about creation, the world is eternal and there are cycles of creation and destruction. There are no endings and beginnings. Hindu creation stories even counter each other and render the others invalid. But neither one is the truth or the false. We can learn from all of them. Hello everyone, I am Preet, and in this video, we will get to know all the major creation stories from the Vedas. So, let's begin. In the 90th Sukta of the 10th Mandal or Book of RigVeda, there is mention of Purush. This Purush is different from the Purush and Prakriti of Sankhya philosophy, which I explained in this video of mine, which you can check out. This Purush from RigVeda is a being with 1000 heads and eyes and hands. It is said that the entire universe from all sides is just as big as 10 times the length of his fingers. Purush is past, present and future. From Purush, Virat was created. Virat contains the omnipresent intelligence which creates the appearance of diversity. In order to create, Purush sacrifices himself, and from his various organs, various things are created, like the sun from his eyes, the moon from his mind, wind and fire from his mouth, the heavens from his head, the earth from his feet, and the space from his ears. So this theory is the first place in any Indian literature where we encounter the thought of unity versus diversity. We are all one and part of Purush, but because of the omnipresence intelligence in Virat, things are different and diverse. Now this is a rather crude meaning of the term which we know today, but it first came from here. In the 121st Sukta of the 10th Mandal of RigVeda, it is mentioned that the source of the creation of cosmos is the Hiranyagarbha. Hiranya means gold and garbha means womb or egg. So Hiranyagarbha means golden womb or golden egg. The entire universe was created from that source, and that source is called Prajapati or Brahma. A note here that this is not the creator deity Brahma of the Trimurti of Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. That idea is from the Puranas. This Brahma refers to the abstract concept of Brahman, which refers to the ultimate reality of universe, who is everything and who created everything. So according to this theory, the universe was created from one single source which embodies the entire reality. We have the third theory of creation in the 129th Sukta of the 10th Mandal of RigVeda. It questions the entire notion of knowing about the creation. It has the lines, "Then there was neither existence nor non-existence. There was no space and no skies. So what happened? Where did it happen? Who did it? Why did he do it?" It contemplates when, by whom and why was the universe created, but doesn't give answer to any question. Who knows? Not even the gods know, because they came after the creation of the universe. Maybe the one from whom this creation arose may know. Or was he mute? Perhaps it formed by itself. Perhaps it did not. Only the one who oversees and preserves the universe from the highest heaven knows. Only he knows. Or maybe even he doesn't know. Who knows? A fun fact that the Nasadiya Sukta, which actually doesn't answer any question about creation and instead questions if you can ever even know about it, is actually called the Hymn of Creation in English. Ironic stuff. The 125th Sukta of the 10th Mandal of RigVeda is called the Devi Sukta. In this Sukta, Devi says that she herself is the creator of everything in the universe. She is the creator, the preserver and the destroyer. She supports and protects all the devas. She is the ultimate reality, but the gods have put her into many different forms. She created the world from inside the eternal ocean, and her breath creates worlds beyond the heavens. Here, Devi herself is saying this confidently that she is the creator. This is particularly rare, and her words are perhaps the boldest and most uncompromising proclamation of being the creator out of any creation story in the Vedas. Now, there isn't much information regarding creation of universe in Yajurved, Samved or Atharved, but there are some fascinating stories in their four subdivisions called Samhitas, Brahmanas, Aranyakas and Upanishads, which we discussed and classified in this video, which you should check out to understand the structure and classification of entire Hindu scriptures. According to the Shatapatha Brahman of Yajurved, formerly only the Prajapati existed, but he wasn't happy. He was all alone. So he split himself into two parts, a male and a female. Then the male and female part kept producing male and female forms of different species of plants and animals. Another story from the Shatapatha Brahman tells that before only Prajapati or Brahma existed, but he wanted to create life from his own body, so he converts himself into an egg and dives into the endless ocean. That egg then evolves into the entire cosmos. Prajapati emerges from the golden egg, creates the earth, the skies, the devas and the asuras. Now this creation story is a mixture of the Purusha Sukta and the Hiranyagarbha theory with elements from both of them. The Aiterya Upanishad of the RigVeda states that in the beginning there existed only Atman or the universal soul. From it, the universe was created in stages. First came the four entities, space, earth, light and water. Then the eight psyches, speech, hearing, sight, in and out breathing, skin, reproductivity and mind. Then the cycle of hunger, thirst and desire, which made the eight psyches and the four entities interdependent on each other. Then humans were created who existed with a part of Atman in them, with that Atman continuously trying to tell the humans that they are more than just their minds. You might have noticed here that I didn't mention the really famous stories like the Trimurti of Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva, where Brahma creates the universe. Also the story of Brahma coming out of Vishnu's navel, or the story of a huge shivling with Vishnu and Brahma racing on it. Well, all these and many other stories come from the Puranas. There are a lot of very fascinating creation stories in the Puranas, so I'll make a separate video for them, so stay tuned for that. Now you guys tell me, which stories did you find the most interesting? Comment all your views and opinions in the comment section below. Please like the video and subscribe to Relevant Myths. Hit the bell icon also so that you never miss my videos. Thank you for watching and have an awesome day.